because there's so much garbage out there. You know, I want to talk about an article I sent out this week, and tonight's listener, Colin, number is 260-356-2611. I sent out an article on Sananda, and what this guy is he's a lookalike of all the pictures we've seen of Jesus. And if you look at all the pictures we have of Jesus and that you've seen in the churches for the past 1,000 or so years, and that is Michelangelo's rendition of what Jesus looks like. I mean, it has nothing to do with what he actually looked like. In fact, it's nothing to do with what he looks like. But he does look like this Sananda. And so all these people that have seen these pictures of Sananda, it's basically what it is. When you see a picture on a wall of Jesus, it's not the real Jesus, the Son of God, it's the Sananda. And they've seen this one in their visions, and they've seen this one in their near-death experiences. And what I learned this week is how prevalent that this Sananda has been working in the spiritual realm behind the scenes, and that he is the one that people are seeing in near-death experiences, that people are seeing when he comes to them in nighttime visitations or dreams or visions, because it's not the real Jesus. You know, there have been several people, myself included, that have seen him, and he looks nothing like these pictures. And so people are being deceived by the Sananda, and all the more for when he comes claiming that he is Jesus, that he is the Son of God, that so many are going to get by his hogwash, hook, line, and sinker. That he's the Son of God, he's going to say the right things, and he's going to have this religious persona about him, and he looks like Jesus, and he has this authority over around him. And you know, the demonic have these demons that can fake personas around people, give somebody a fake aura of religiousness about them, of holiness, and it's all demonic. It's just a charade. And because when people see him and you know, he's healing them, he's healing their limbs, and he's healing their diseases, and he's raising the dead, and everything that Jesus originally did when he was here, they're not going to see him as an evil person, as the evil being that he really is. They're going to see him as something righteous and something religious, and they're going to buy his lies that he's the Son of God. And, of course, we know in Matthew 24, forewarned of those that would come in his name. And so we've been forewarned, and this is part of it. But the whole reason the Sarah is really going to get bigger in these days is not only because they're establishing themselves in all the countries, is they have the entire agenda of the Antichrist for when he comes. And I've spent a lot of time this week going through some of the information that I, you know, secondhandly stumbled onto. And I guess it's better for me to be sent the stuff and go through it than a lot of you have to go fish through these sites, you know, looking for truth or what's going on. Obviously, you're not going to find any truth. But what you're going to find is their agenda and the things that they have in store for man and why our government keeps denying it. And the reason they keep denying it is because it's supposed to happen suddenly and all at once, and it's not supposed to be something that's published beforehand. It's not supposed to be something that's well-known beforehand. They want to take people by surprise, you know, and they want to do things their own way. They want to control this whole thing themselves. And so, you know, that's why our government has always had an official policy of denial whenever it comes to something of UFOs or outer space beings. And that's what these things are, Sananda and Jermaine. They are Anak. They're the Anunnaki that are going to come down and this whole Ascended Masters thing and this whole Galactic Federation. I knew that was garbage, and I'm going to tell you about it tonight. This whole Galactic Federation thing and the Ashtar Command, and these are simply different vessels of Lucifer that he's using. They're all working together. You know, they wanted us to think that this Galactic Federation, and you've heard about it in Star Wars, you wanted us to think that they were looking out for Earth and that, you know, they're the UN of all these terrestrial races out there. And now it's a bunch of garbage. No one's looking out for Earth, I'll tell you that much. The only person that you can put your hope and your faith in is Yahushua, is the Lord Jesus Christ, the real Son of God. Because every other little vessel out there Lucifer has is all being used to be prepared to destroy America, to destroy this world, and not just our country, even though America will be the home base. You know, I was just reading something, where did I put it, on Russia this week. And Russia's military movements are beginning to move. They're going to a Siberian military district. What they're doing is they're heading all of their militaries underneath to an underground city beneath Yamantau Gora Mountain. Probably didn't pronounce it right. And then a lot of frantic activity going under there, or getting out of the way of the coast. Thousands of animals migrating towards the interior spaces between the mountains and the coastal areas in Russia. They're anticipating some major earth damage coming this way. Whenever they say earth changes, you know, it's just a nice way of saying a lot of earth damage is coming. And so Russia's preparing for it. Russia's heading into the mountains, into their underground cities. And that's going on this week. And so, you know, there could be stuff coming to our end of the atmosphere over here, the Western Hemisphere. I don't know. I don't know of anything particular coming this week, but it's, you know, we always have to keep our eyes out. We know that the coastlines are going to be flooding. They're going to, you know, this whole, the earthquakes, we've got 1,500 active volcanoes now. And from what I could tell last year when I was working in the codes is that all of this, you know, all of these earth disasters that they call changes, nothing but earth damage, annihilations, and holocausts, is a preamble. It's a preamble to this whole coming Nisera thing. And by the time this Nisera thing's even announced and these Sananda and Germain freaks are here and the government's under their control, we could be in martial law. We could be missing a couple of coastlines. I mean, this world's going to be in a lot of destruction. And so I've always seen that, and I've always seen May as a dominant month, not only for the announcement of this Nisera, but for martial law in America because of all of the damage and destruction done. You know, they want to tell you that they're coming here to help Earth. Well, it's their coming that's destroying Earth. You know, their Dark Star, their Nu, their Sedna, all of these orb stars and planets and ships that are coming to Earth are what's upsetting the Earth's balance. You know, they're coming into our solar system to have this, well, you could, you know, I'll call it, it's a hostile takeover. You can call it whatever you want. Nothing more than a hostile takeover coming in the name of peace and prosperity. But it's their mere presence that's destroying our Earth. You know, they want to tell us that it's Earth changes and that it's going to keep evolving. Well, you know, what they wanted was for the Earth's atmosphere to evolve into a Garden of Eden atmosphere once again. And so they have big plans of making that happen. You know, and they have all kinds of big plans for the peaceful takeover of our world. You know, I these oxymoronic terms that people always like to use, they'll call something patriotic when it's nothing but imprisoning, or they'll call something peaceful when it's nothing but hostile. And, you know, they switch everything around. You know, black is white, white is black, good is evil, evil is good. I mean, this is just the agenda of Satan. That's how he operates, and you're seeing it every day. You know, so I want, not only did the Sananda article raise a lot of eyebrows over the internet this week, you know, I posted it to a lot of lists, and of course, beings that are supporting him are just coming out of the woodwork. And let me tell you what the Bible reveals about some of these people, what I found in the codes. And I have a website on these at OmegansAreLiars.com. You may not know what Omegans are, but Omegans are Satan's last days armies. And they don't just include aliens, although aliens, these fallen angel beings, are a big bulk of his last days armies. They also include the humans, the politicians, and the militaries, and the governments, the people in these positions that support them. You know, they're Omegan. They're part of his last days army. And so that's why you'll hear people refer to them as Omegans or Anax. You know, Anax is just one branch, the majority, the dominant branch of Satan's armies. And they look human. They look, you know, they're about 7 feet tall, blonde hair, blue-eyed, very beautiful beings. They're going to come as angels, and a lot of people are going to buy it. You know, because they look angelic. They can have this fake aura that makes them look like they're glowing and in light. And they're going to, and they're going to fool a lot of people. But all they are fallen angels. You know, Lucifer was an Anak, or an angel before he fell.